More than likely, if you browse through a website, it has been styled using classes. A class is used to set styling once, and then we can apply that class to any element we want. And the outcome? Consistency in styling, especially when you're working with a team on the same site. But more importantly, we can build on that. If you make a change on a class, every other element with that class applied gets updated too. In this video, we'll learn how to do that in Webflow, and we'll do it in 6 steps. We'll create a class and then use it. We'll go over how to manage classes, edit, rename, remove, and even learn how to duplicate them. We'll go into combo classes and then global classes, also called utility classes. Second to last, we'll talk about the difference between a base, combo, and a global class. And finally, we'll look into how to manage it all through the style selectors panel. Before we jump into the first step, let's make sure that we know what style selectors are. A selector is how Webflow knows what to style. When you apply a class to an element, you're creating a selector, our class. And then, that class stores the styles which can then be reused on other elements. Another type of selector, HTML tags, allow you to style all of the same element, like all paragraphs or all H1 headings. But for this video, we'll be focusing on classes. We have a separate lesson on HTML tags, so go ahead and check that out if you haven't already. All right, creating and using base classes. Here, on this side, we have this button selected, and if we go up here to the style selector, we'll click in and give our class a name. Let's call it main button, and we'll press return. We created the class, but nothing happened. That's because we haven't added any styles to it. So if we go into our style panel, here on the right, we can add some spacing properties, like padding and margin. That looks decent. Let's change the background color. We'll use one of our accent colors, and we can also adjust the font size here. And finally, let's choose a color variable for our text. Okay, we created a class and we added style properties to that class. So if I go and apply that main button class to our other button here, let's make sure it's selected, and back up here in our style selector, we'll find and apply that class. Just like that, this button has the same styling as the one we styled first. And it's because it has the same class applied to it, the main button class. Now, when we adjust our spacing or whatever styling properties we want on this class, it affects both of these buttons because it has the same class. One thing you might have noticed, when we made these styling changes earlier on that class, our main button, a blue label appeared. That means it is inheriting its styles from this class. It's a fundamental concept in CSS, and we'll talk about it later in this lesson when we get to combo classes. That's creating and using a base class. Let's get into managing classes, and we'll start with editing, which we already started doing, but let's look into it a bit deeper. With this other button selected, which still has the main class we created just a moment ago, let's edit our class. We're just changing the spacing here again. It changes on both, we know that. But there are some things to know about how classes work on different breakpoints. If we go to tablet mode, we can see that the label is now amber. And if we click in, we can see that the value is coming from the desktop breakpoint. Let's change the top margin here on tablet, just creating a little bit more breathing room here. And when we go back to desktop, we still have this value. But back in our tablet breakpoint, we have a different value. This is because styles cascade down from larger breakpoints, but not up from smaller breakpoints. There's a lot more to this, and we do have separate coverage on this topic over at Webflow University and the Help Center. Okay, renaming a class. That's helpful if you need to name your classes more clearly for consistency, to help you and your team find and reuse them. You can just click in and start typing. Or you can select the little arrow here and choose rename. Once you rename that class, it will change everywhere it's being used. And to be clear, we're just renaming that class. It doesn't affect any styling changes. Okay, removing a class. That is helpful when you don't want that element to have styles from that class. You can click in and delete it. Or, let's undo real quick, you can click on the tiny arrow and remove it. The element keeps its current styling, but it doesn't inherit any updates from that class we removed, because we removed it. The last one here before we move on to the next step is duplicating. Duplicating is helpful if you want to build on from that class. You want to keep the styles, but you want to use it somewhere else and not affect this class. Same idea here, click the little arrow and duplicate. Now, we have a good starting point, but this class is a completely separate new class. Anything you do in this class now won't affect the original class you copied it from. All right, that's managing our classes. Next up, combo classes. A combo class is a variation of a base class, but what does that even mean and when would you want to use one? You would want to use it when you have elements that share most of the styling with the base class, but you need a few changes for a specific thing. For example, like when you have a different background color. Basically, combo classes allow you to override specific styles without breaking the connection to the core styling defined by that base class. Back in Webflow, with our button selected, which already has that class applied, we'll click in and we'll create a new combo class. We can name it something like isDark. Now we can edit the styling on this combo class. We're just changing the background color and the font color. And the base styling is still there, and it didn't change our other class. And to confirm this, we'll go in closer here in the style panel. Styles that are set directly on a class show in blue and are inherited styles. And if we edit or update our base class, we'll select this class here, and we change things, that class is updated as well. However, it won't update if it's one of the specific properties we set on that combo class. That's combo classes. Let's talk about global classes, sometimes called utility classes. A global class is a standalone style you can apply on top of any element. It's not tied to a base or a combo class and usually serves a single purpose, like spacing, alignment, and visual effects. Let's say you want your shadow to be consistent on all your buttons, cards, and images. Instead of adding that drop shadow property on every single base or combo class, you can create that global class. Here in Webflow, a good way to do that is to drag in an element, like a div block. It's temporary to create the class. And we're doing this not to accidentally create a combo class on top of an existing class. Global classes are meant to be applied independently on top of other classes, not as a variation of another class, a combo class. With our div block selected, we can start by naming our class. We'll type in uShadowMedium. And let's scroll down here and we'll add our drop shadow. We have the perfect one memorized, so I'm just adding that in real quick. Once it's added here in this class, we can layer it here in our selector field on an element we want it on. So with our button selected, we'll start typing in our class name. And there it is. We can select that global class we just created. And now it is applied to that button without affecting the base class or the combo class. And while we're at it, we can apply it to our card here. And let's also apply it to this image. Click in, select, and there it is. And remember, you can always see the inheritance of the styles in the style panel. Also, a quick note, since we've used that temporary element and already created our class, we can go ahead and delete that element. The class will still exist and you can use it whenever you need it. It will only not exist if it is removed from all the elements and manually cleaned up. More on that in our last step. All right, that's global classes. Let's compare all these class types real quick. Base class, combo class, and a global class. Base classes are applied directly to an element. They store all the CSS properties you want for that element. You apply that class to other elements. They all match and are easy to edit and change. You usually use base classes to get started styling an element. Then, combo classes are layered on top of the base classes. They inherit all the base styles, but they allow you to be more specific and override with new style properties. So you usually use combo classes when you want to stack a small change on the class, like for a light or dark variation. Finally, we have global classes. They are completely independent from the base and the combo class. They're standalone styles you can apply to any element, ideal for something like a shadow. That's really it, how they work together and the core difference between them. Let's wrap this up and look into the Style Selectors panel. The Style Selectors panel is where you have an overview of all your classes. It's a complete list of every selector on your site, your styled HTML tags, represented in pink, your base classes, which are blue, and then there's the combo classes that are blue with a curved arrow icon to show which base class they're comboing with. And a few things worth mentioning here. You can hover over a selector to see the CSS that's in that class. We can come up here and search for a specific class. We can even rename a class by clicking on the wrench icon. And lastly, you can see where each class is being used, on the current page you're on, other pages, and what components they are a part of. And one last thing here, every class you create will show up in here, even if it's not applied to an element. The only way to get rid of unused styles is to come up here and clean up any unused styles. Just one click and another. Keep in mind, this will also remove all global classes and any classes defined in custom code that aren't being used anywhere. Okay, We covered a lot. Let's recap real quick. We showed how to create and use base classes. We edited, renamed, removed, and even duplicated a class. We built a combo class on top of our base class. We created a global class, also known as a utility class. We then summarized the difference between those three. And finally, we showed how to manage it all in the style selectors panel. That's classes in Webflow.